¿Qué pasa, mi familia?
We recorded this video, and at the end of the video, which was over 30 minutes, the sound wasn't working. We didn't do a sound check, so...
We like to suffer.
We're doing this for the YouTube.
So today, we're going to repeat our suffering, this time with voice, and we verified, so we're not going to do it a third time.
No, we're not going to do this a third time.
Because my butthole did not like it the first time.
Okay.
We have the challenge of White Lightning. We decided to pursue doing one of these challenges. You know, we wanted to kind of stem away from our usual videos, which is, you know, we like to do these little man and woman type of beauty product reviews and stuff like that. But this time we want to do something a little bit more funny, a little bit more crazy. So with this challenge here, I'm sure most of you have seen the hottest chip in the world challenge or something like that. And we were considering about doing that, but,
that was,
you know,
like $50 on Amazon.
Yeah, it was like $50 for a single
chip. For one chip.
Yeah, that the Rona got people, you know, deucing to do stuff. But we found, it's actually the same company, isn't it, that does that? Or maybe not.
I don't know.
In
I just
case.
Found this one. I just looked up challenge, and this came up. And
yeah.
So,
with this challenge, it's a piece of chocolate that's also the hottest in the world. Aside from, you know, having us suffer, you know, at our own discretion, the main reason why we wanted to do this challenge is because, like, the company itself has, you know, I would say, like, a very good mission statement. So from every box of these that they sell, 50 meals get donated to Feed America or Feed the Hunger. Feeding America. I got it right the first time.
Yes.
And so ultimately, that's kind of the main reason why we wanted to do this. Yes.
So I saw this, and it's on Amazon. You can see it when you swipe through the pictures. It says...
And click that affiliate link below.
Yes. It says, before the pandemic, 37 million people in the United States were facing hunger. 11 million of those are children. That number has already increased by 17 million and counting as a result of school closures, unemployment, and poverty due to COVID-19. So these 11 million children have increased to 17 million. Feeding America needs our help to the tune of $1.4 billion.
It's all for a very good cause.
Yes. On Amazon, it's $24.95 with a $2 coupon.
Woo-hoo!
I know.
But all right, so to the back of it says, a marriage between good and evil. The Choco Challenge is for the pain-seeking masochist who wants to join the fight to end hunger but also has no regard for their own self-well-being.
We don't.
That's us.
At all.
So then below that, hence late to pair with white chocolate, an unreleased salt pepper blend comes with a mad scientist smoking Ed Curry's secret garden of devilish delights.
So the only thing here is that we are going to... twist it up or spice it up. No pun intended. We're going to be asking each other questions.
The inside of the box. Let's take a look. Ah, look, it's a red thing. Because red means passion and death and fire.
Danger means fire and danger.
Fire, danger, and passion. But
not
the inside of it says,
in
you must be insane to consume this pain. And when you take out the little thing out the chocolate, if I can get my sausage fingers in there. Oh, look at that. There's a little devil in there, too.
Yeah, it's a cute little square. It's like a what, an inch and a half?
Something like
inch
that.
Inch and a half by an inch and a half.
It's like the size of a Ghirardelli, pretty much. Yeah, that's a chocolate.
Ghirardelli?
Ah, yeah, whatever. But the inside of the box actually says, last chance to turn back.
So there's ample warning signs.
If you have, like, GI tract issues or... You know,
heart issues.
Pacemaker, if you're pregnant, it's probably not smart to do this.
Oh, that's right. There's a warning. If you get burned up, try eating some bread or drinking some milk. Eat at your own risk, you maniacs. In this case, I don't like chugging milk like that. We have vanilla ice cream because we love vanilla and we love ice cream.
Because we fancy like that.
We are. Okay. Are you ready?
Let's pop this bad boy open.
Let me grab a napkin because...
stuff starts to leak out of every orifice. You can just return it. Oh, too, like you already opened it.
I already opened it.
I'm going to return mine, guys.
No, we're doing this together. So this is the little square. This looks like it's the oil that hardened when you cooked
bacon.
Bacon
fat.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like compressed.
That's what it looks like.
Bacon fat.
It looks like it has little bacon pieces, and I think I'm just going to pretend it has bacon pieces.
That's what it looks like, guys. Yeah.
It's been nice knowing you.
It's been nice knowing you too, GI Tract.
Okay, ready? Go. Mm. So it's immediately spicy as soon as it hits your tongue. Mm.
How come it didn't? Oh, wait, no, there it goes.
Mm. But it is sweet.
Mm-hmm.
So one side effect that I noticed immediately was that my saliva starts to like thicken up, and it's not like here up in the front. I mean, it's spicy, but I mean, unless you really don't like spicy, I don't think you'll actually die from it. It's spicy like in the manner of, you know, if you had like really good Indian food or if like your mom made a bomb salsa. Oh, there it goes. There goes the saliva. It's starting to pull in my mouth again.
Ooh. I honestly don't know how you're talking.
What was I saying? But yeah, it's not bad.
I'm gonna drink a little water.
At least for me, it doesn't feel like it's that bad now, up front. But I'm wondering if, like, you know, the back end of it.
I'm, like, panicking.
Are you sweating?
No.
You're glistening, babe. You're glistening.
You want to ask those questions?
Oh, yeah. We should probably do that. That ice cream looks pretty good, doesn't it? Let's just put this over here. All right. I think we should consume the other half. And then ask those questions because... By the way, before we do that, I'm just going to show you guys. I'm not even kidding. You guys see that? It's disgusting.
Ew, it's in your beard.
Oh, my bad. I'll save that from later. Yeah, like, that's my saliva. My skin is kind of, my mouth is getting freaked out.
My ears are popping.
Are they itchy? Is it the itchy ear type of spicy?
No.
Your leg's shaking uncontrollably. It's like you got Parkinson's, like Michael J. Fox under your foot.
Like Thumper.
Like Thumper. I am not going to
drink. Oh, anymore. My ears.
You got a little more right here. It's right there. Oh, my bad.
Stop.
I didn't touch it with this
one. I know, no. You're going to stop it.
Yeah, it's okay. It's not crazy. Your eyes are like really watery, though.
Yeah.
Oh. Ah. It does coat the tongue, no lie. And it lingers for a while. I also feel like my voice got deeper, too, for some reason.
A whole octave?
Okay, let's take the other half. Ready? Ready, three.
Wait, I'm Wait. I'm trying to take a breath.
It's not that spicy.
Maybe not for you, but...
Well, it's not spicy for here, but like I said, my GI tract has gone through years and years of damage from eating very spicy food. And it affects more my stomach than it does my structure up here.
Okay. Well, mind over matter, right?
Look at this, guys. You guys.
Ew.
That's all saliva. That's pretty awesomely disgusting.
Oi. Oh,
hey, felt a little runniness. A little. I could smell something. It smells like Fritos.
Woo!
Is that the dog's feet? Smelling Fritos? Okay, let's take a bite.
Ready?
Round two. And now, start the questions. Oh, yeah. The second one wasn't as hot up front.
Mm-mm.
But my saliva got like really... Oh, my saliva got really thick, and it got really spicy in my esophagus.
Okay.
First question. Is cereal a soup? Why or why not?
Hold on, I got it stuck in my teeth.
10, 9, 8.
No.
7, why not? 6.
Because it has milk.
Yogurt has dairy in it, and there's lots of soups with yogurt. Those are soup. Next question.
My turn. Okay.
I love her face. Just pick a random question. Doesn't need to be
that. Okay.
It's kind of spicy, guys. It's starting to get to me a little bit.
What's invisible but you wish people could see?
My fart clouds. Especially like those people that get like the silent but deadly kind. There's like... And then it just kind of disperses.
Oh, wow.
Look.
Ew. All
right. Next question. Is a hot dog a sandwich?
No.
Why not? It's got a bun. It's got meat in the bun. Here you go, man. Because I love you. And I don't need any water. Because I am Mexican.
Oh, gosh.
With Julie.
What is... Oh, gosh. Okay, go.
Oh, that was a question.
Oh, what...
Why, why isn't it? It's got a bun and meat. Why isn't it a sandwich?
Because it's its own thing.
No, it's... Okay, next one.
Woo-wee! What is something... That everyone looks what stupid doing? I can't even read.
Eating space junk. Oh, that went down the pipe. Okay, it's fine until it goes down the wrong pipe. Oh wow, that is not pleasant, guys. What? Okay, what does people look stupid when they do this and they record?
I can't do this mind over matter.
My eyes are teary now. Next one. In 40 years, what will people be nostalgic for?
Shopping without a mask.
That's a pretty good one. Now, oh, cool. I'm gonna suck this up.
Woo! Toilet paper over or under?
It's gotta be over. Who does it under? Crazy people. And this is actually a proven fact. If you look up the patent of how, if you look up the patent of toilet paper, the photo has the toilet paper going over, which means that under people, I don't care if you got a cat, you've been wrong.
I can't do this.
Next one. How many chickens would it take to kill an elephant? Oh man, don't blow your nose.
You blew your nose in the napkin that you've been spitting into.
Oh, maybe that's what it is. Oh god.
I'm like my snot just came.
Oh, your snot also spicy.
I think you got it in your beer, let me see.
Yeah, don't touch your junk when you're in the, using the bathroom, and don't blow your nose either.
Mm-mm. I've been blowing my nose, it's fine, but you've been spitting into your napkins.
Oh, yeah, maybe that's what it is. What's the most embarrassing thing you've ever worn?
I don't know.
Can I answer that?
Yeah.
Adult plus woman's dress when I dress up as sexy Wendy for Halloween. Yeah. Shouts out to my Halloween playthings. Okay.
Okay, so the ice cream is definitely
I'm gonna suck it up.
So I failed. I'm okay with that.
Give me that shit. Give me that shit.
No, you said you want to suck it up.
Okay. I sucked up my snot.
No, because you're a man. No. No. Do you feel better?
No, yeah, it definitely helps.
I think so.
I can give you the science of why ice cream works. Mm. And honestly, anything with milk or just dairy in general.
My stomach is upset. And it's not the ice cream.
The fat molecules.
Content.
Oversaturate the capsaicin. Because it's chocolate contains fat, so the capsaicin sticks to that. But by using more fat to cover that, that's why it helps temporarily. With spicy food, usually water don't work. But you can have ice cream that usually pretty good. But yeah, it's not that bad, guys.
It is not of the for the faint of stomach.
Okay, what is one last question? What would be the coolest animal to scale up to the size of a horse?
A dog.
How did I know you were going to say that? A dog?
A dog? Specifically mine.
I would...
Sorry. I like coughed all over my stuff. What was I going to say?
What kind of animal would you scale to the size of a horse?
A chipmunk. The chipmunks are cute. Squirrels are not. I actually stepped on a chipmunk once. I was getting prepared to go, I think it was like Wisconsin Dells with my brother. And it was like 4 in the morning. We're going to start driving. Oh man, this live is like just... It just will not stop producing. And it was nighttime. I was going to put the stuff in the car. And then I like stepped on something and it squeaked. It's like, eek. And it felt squishy too.
Oh.
So I'm like, what the hell is that?
And my brother's like, oh, you probably stepped on the chipmunk. He lives underneath the stairs. Like, I just killed the chipmunk. He's like, nah, he's fine. If he's not there, he's okay. He died of internal bleeding from having this giant elephant step on him. You want to hear a funny joke in Spanish?
Sure, sure.
So there was an elephant with, he's a chipmunk in this case. On the elephant, that was the chipmunk. They were playing baseball.
Oh.
And the little mouse, he's up to bat. He's getting ready with his little mouse bat.
His little mouse bat? What is it?
And the elephant's like, I give up. And then the little mouse is like, beat him. And then the elephant just drops his glove and he starts running up to him and he stomped him.
Okay.
Porque lo picho.
Aww.
Beat him. And he went.
It's a Spanglish joke.
So it translates to, there was a mouse who said, come on, give it to me. And the elephant's like, here it comes. And the mouse said, pichame, which, you know, it's like Spanglish, like pitch it to me. Pichame. But because he was a mouse, he couldn't really pronounce like S's. So the elephant thought that he was saying pichame, like step on me. So that's why the elephant stepped on the mouse instead of pitching him.
It's a cute story. cute joke. Honestly, like with how hot this is, like I'm blanking out and I don't know.
I am getting kind of giggly, don't lie.
My
like
ears
SpongeBob.
Popped. There's all this pressure.
Did you get the itchiness?
No, I just got my ears. No, it was just popping. In our other video.
These are all the napkins that I use,
guys. With the whitening strips, I caught myself like several times being spacey or trying to...
Saying teeth like 8 times.
Yeah. So I found myself in the video like having a hard time concentrating. And then I think I burped. So I was trying to like... pretend everything was okay, and later on that day, my stomach wasn't hurting. It was upset.
My stomach was hurting. Well, it wasn't hurting, but it was like really bugging me. Like, you ever have to go take like a really bad poop, and then but you like wait because you're like doing something.
Yes.
It was like
terrible stories.
But the problem was that it's like your stomach kind of turned. It's like
yeah, like oh.
It's like you got to fart.
It's painful.
Yeah.
It's like cramping.
And honestly, it was like that.
Diarrhea cramps. That's what it is.
Yeah, it's that. I definitely noticed that. Like for the rest of that day, my stomach kind of felt that way. So I'll probably exhibit that again.
You know, it's funny that you say that. Because my stomach was hurting. I don't know if you guys saw me. I was like, ugh, like this. That's because my stomach was hurting. Oh.
It was all the juice marinating inside of your stomach.
My stomach, my poor stomach was like, not again. Please help me. She's enduring all this abuse.
Are you crazy? So pick another random question.
Okay, by the way, I'm sorry. This is what I want to say. Conversationstartersworld.com. That's the name of the website. What would be the creepiest thing you could say while passing a stranger on the street?
I was like at a bar or something like that, and this random person, they're like, oh, can I touch your beard? And I was already kind of somewhat intoxicated, and I'm like, can I touch your eyelids? And I looked at him just like that, like, can I touch your eyelids? Never again. So if you ever need a way to creep somebody out, and they're like, oh, can I touch your hair? Can I touch your eyeball? No, you can't say eyeball. It's got to be something like very weird. Can I touch the inside of your elbow?
Inside of your elbow?
Can I touch the flap of your left nostril?
That's weird. That is kind of creepy.
So, you know, you gotta play that psychology
game. Be creepy with more creepy.
Yeah.
If you were arrested with no explanation, what would your friends and family assume you had done?
You got in a fight, didn't you?
I got caught speeding. Oh.
Extra juicy.
No, extra spicy. And then the ice cream.
Hey, then the cream just mixed up all in it.
Okay.
For every Choco Challenge bar purchase, 50 meals will be donated to local food banks to end hashtag end hunger. We're doing good deeds, homies.
So yes, so we'll include the link for this. Do it and post the video. We want to laugh with you guys.
With that, click the link below. And in the end, we're helping people. We're helping to feed some people today. Thanks for joining us on this one episode of Choco Challenge.
The Choco Challenge. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please like, share, and comment.
Hit that little bell. That's what they say, right? You gotta hit that little bell. But I believe that does it.
Yeah.
For Beauty and the Beard.
The Beauty and the Beard. I didn't get the hiccups this time.
Yeah, that, I actually kind of missed that. Maybe we can put that as like a little clip at the end. It will
like the
voice over the hiccups.